Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge, back with another tutorial for you. This time is another request through my comments section that somebody wanted to know how to make an ancient bronze shader in Blender, and that was a really cool challenge for me. So here is how I would go about doing it. And after watching this video, you'll be able to also. Ready? Let's go. So to show you the setup really quickly, I quickly modeled the simple vase, and I also have this kind of quasi-fake photographic draped backdrop and some lights around hitting this, and kind of object is dead center, and the camera's just looking at the object dead center. All right, very simple setup. You can probably set this up too. So when we go ahead and create this shader, the first thing I did was I looked at some reference material. And if we look at reference material for ancient bronze, which is pretty much just a copper alloy, you see that it's in various states of oxidation, pretty rough. And I've seen a lot of tutorials go into how to create this by just creating, you know, a simple bronze color and then adding a, you know, green over it. And that kind of works. And some people, you know, like I know Zacharias Reinhardt went in and did a really awesome tutorial on taking the ambient occlusion shader and going in and doing stuff. And that's really, really cool. And it works really, really well. But if I'm looking at this stuff and I'm saying, all right, well, this is really, really rough and built up. And even a few other examples here, like you can see that it's pretty rough. So how would I go ahead and create this? Well, I could do it with just grabbing, you know, any kind of image map, like something like this off the internet, and laying it over and playing with roughness. And that's a really quick way, photographically great way to do it. But I want to do this procedurally, and it's kind of a cool challenge. So I'm looking at this and I'm saying, all right, well, this is layered. There's a lot of little things happening in here. So I can build up a shader network that does this, and then I can have ultimate control over how I want it to look for a number of different objects. And a number of different scenes and things that I would create, right? Because if I did it with just a texture map, I'm kind of locked into that. But if I do it procedurally, I can kind of just tweak it to my heart's content. That's what we're gonna do in this video. So to do that, I'm gonna start building up my little shader network. So the first thing I'll do is figure out the base color. So my base color here, and for those who wanna know, I'm in EEVEE, base color is kind of in the copper realm. So I'll just quickly give it a copper shader. Something that looks copperish. All right, so maybe a little more red, but bronze is an alloy, so I'll just leave it there. And it's metallic, so I'll whack the metallic all the way up. And roughness here, you have really shiny, highly polished, or you have really, really, really rough. So this really doesn't matter because we're gonna control all of this stuff with other things, but that gives us a good start. So the first thing I'll do is start building up the layers. I'm gonna start adding in different nodes. So I can go to add, or I can hit shift A, and I'm gonna start by adding in a ramp. So I'm gonna go to converter, I'm gonna go color ramp, and I'm gonna drag this color into my shader. So I want it to be both, okay? So you can just click and drag, and that's a cool shortcut. And what I'll do is I'll just take this and make it just a little bit darker and maybe pull it more into just a little bit more reddish. And now I have a ramp going, and I'll plug that into base color here. And now it's kind of mixing the two. And I'm gonna control this. Okay, this is gonna be our first splotchy pattern. So I'm gonna control that with a texture. So I'm gonna go shift A, and I'll go in and I'll say texture, and I'll say Musgrave, and I'll plug factor into factor. And you'll see here that it'll start giving me different shaders. So if I take this from linear and I put it on constant, you could see that we're starting to get some breakup. So if I start playing with the scale here, it's gonna start giving me this nice kind of broken up pattern. And I can change FBM here to multi-fractal, and it'll kind of start putting this everywhere. So now I'll break it up. So scale here, I'll pull back down 14, detail, I'll leave it 16, and the magic here is this lacunarity, if I'm pronouncing that right. Okay, push that up, and you start getting some breakup. Push it up a lot, happy spot here where you start getting quite a bit of nice breakup. So there, it's cool. Dimension I'll take down. And detail I'll put up at 16. And it's starting to really kind of look cool. And if I pull this back now, you can start seeing we're getting a nice breakup, okay? So this is good for our first layer. Pretty good start. So I'll pull this away, and I'll pull this away, and I'm gonna add in another one. Because if we look, quite a bit going on here, right? So what I can do now is I can duplicate this by hitting Shift D, pull it down, okay? And I'll give a different shader here. So I'll make this kind of more yellowish, maybe a little lighter. I could take this, maybe pull that a little darker, and I'm gonna mix RGB so I can mix those two together with another shader. So again, either add or Shift A, doesn't matter. And I'm gonna go to color, mix RGB, drop that over here, plug color to color, and now you're getting a mix. And this is mixing here with this factor. So we need to break that up and control that with another Musgrave texture. So I'm gonna grab that, hit Shift D, duplicate, pull that guy up, put factor to factor, and now just change these numbers. So I'll push the scale up, 20, detail, leave it 16. Lacunarity here, I can play with and kind of push way up or leave it as is. And then change multifractal, because that's just kind of repeating this pattern, to like FBM, and it gives me a different look, and we're starting to really break this up. And you can see that we're starting to get some really nice kind of disturbing patterns in this alloy here, in this metal. So let's go ahead and add in a color ramp here, and that'll kind of neutralize this push. So watch this. Shift A, converter, color ramp, throw that in there, and we can start kind of neutralizing that extreme push. And lastly, we can go ahead and change these areas here. So the more we change this, the more kind of an organic push we start getting. And there you see we have a nice breakup. And this is a little too saturated for my liking, so I'll pull that back. And there we go. Next, let's start adding the oxidation. So to do that, I want a completely different shader. I don't want to use this shader tree. I want complete control over that. So I want this to have a different shininess than the green oxidation. So what I'll do is I'll add in a node here. It'll mix shader right here, and then we can pull out and do completely different shader on here and mix it together. So I'll go to shader, mix shader, push that in, and I'll just borrow from this guy. So Shift D, change this guy to a kind of that bluish green color. I'll pull these over so we have more space. And I'm gonna plug him up to this shader. And you'll see now, it's gonna mix it in with green. Make this a little bit lighter. There we go. So now we need to break this up too. So to do that, we're gonna control it just like we've been doing. All right, and I'll use a Musgrave. I kind of like that texture. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. And I'll use that as a factor here to throw in and break this up. So I can borrow a Musgrave texture from here, or I can just hit Shift A, go to texture, hit Musgrave, pull it up so it's not gonna wire itself up. Factor to factor, and here we start having this. Now, what's happening here in the mix shader is like before, except even more. You see it's really pushing this into red here. So this, even though it's factor, it's still really pushing this saturation. So here's where we really want to put that color ramp in. So again, we can just steal the color ramp here, just hit Shift A, it doesn't matter. Go to converter, color ramp, throw that in and watch. Now it neutralizes it. All right, so that brings it back home. And now we can play with where we want to put this guy. So I can up the scale. I can up the detail. All right. And this, like, unlike rust, this oxidation seems to happen a little more gradually. So we don't have to push the detail all the way up, so it's not like a harsh line. You can if you want, but in all the references I've seen, it's more of a gradient push, right? Take the dimension down, doesn't matter. And lacunarity here, we can use to break it up. Right, so we start to break it up and throw it over, and it starts to look kind of natural. And then we can control we can also use this to control just how much or how little we have of that shader. So we have two controls here. We have the scale and we have this. And now we can work on the shader. So if you looked at a lot of the examples in the beginning here, it's kind of rough, right? Kind of like there's almost like a bumpy texture on this oxidation that you can see here. It's pretty rough in here, right? So let's go ahead and add that. So I can do that with a bump map. So for this shader here, I'll throw in a bump. To do that, just hit Shift A, go to Vector, Bump, okay, Normal to Normal. And then over here, all right, so we're in this shader, I'll add in a noise texture. Noise seems to be pretty good for this sort of thing. So I'll hit Shift A, Texture, Noise. Now we take the factor and we put it into height. All right, by default, it'll throw it into normal, put it into height. And if I zoom in closer, EEVEE's taking a little while to catch up here. You can see it starts bumping this out. So if I throw this scale way up, and I'm leaving the strength at 1 here so you can see the effect, okay? You take the detail, push that up, you start getting some really nice bump. Now this works really well for rust, not so much for the oxidation, so you wanna kinda take that down and kinda just have it kinda subtle. And that's looking decent. So what else we can do here is we can play with the look so it's not so uniform, is I can just add a color in here. So I can add a ramp just to the base color. Shift A, I can go converter, color ramp. Again, I can click on the white, I can take this color, click and drag, throw it in here to drop the color, put the color in here, and now you'll see it kind of breaks this up here. So it's not so uniform. And if I wanted to show you how much of that is happening here, you could see I could take, like, this is just for illustration purposes here, right? We're going from red to green. Let's pull that back. And we can control it with a factor. So I'll throw in a Musgrave in here as well. So Shift A, again, texture, Musgrave, throw that guy in here, factor to factor. And you'll see that we're getting green and red here. I'm obviously not going to leave red because that's not right. And we break it up, scale it, add some detail, lacunarity, we can break it up. And now I can change that back into this area here, control it more, and really start getting a nice kind of breakup. And you can add more in here to this too. You can go ahead and add different colors in here if you want. Maybe add a little bit of yellow, all right, and just start really roughing it up. And the whole point is that you want to go in and just break it up. You don't want it to look so uniform, okay? Because if you looked at the references, it's not all uniform. And that starts getting it really, really rough and looking pretty good right off the bat. So what's left is we have too much of a shine here. Now, if you polished it, yeah, sure. But if it's ancient, this roughness on the metal here, all right, so here's the roughness on our shader. So let's push this roughness all the way up because the oxidation, it's not shiny, okay? This stuff is not shiny. It's pretty matte. So we push that roughness all the way up and that gives it a nice flat look. But for our alloy, okay, for our copper, we don't want it to be so uniformly shiny. So here you could see it's uniformly shiny, right? Where the copper is, we don't want that. So you can control it and you can really kind of make it rough if it's really ancient and worn, or we can go ahead and just add in another shader here to control that. So we can go by where patina is happening by borrowing from here. So we could just take this mix node and pull it in, or just for the sake of this video, I can just add a roughness here and it's not gonna make too much of a difference. I can steal one of these Musgrave textures, Shift D, pull it in here, take the color, plug it into roughness, and I'll pull him out and I'll add in a ramp in here. So Shift A, see that's way too crazy, right? Shift A, converter, color ramp, throw that guy in there. And now we can have from shiny to completely matte if we want. Or I can take this, pull it up a little bit, and just have more control. And this will give you a lot more control and a lot more breakup. And this starts looking pretty crazy. Now, lastly, for this shader, is our saturation values. Okay, our saturation values here are probably a little much if we're going for that kind of ancient, really ancient bronze, where we want kind of more of the oxidation and less less color left. Okay, so if you look at this, this not much of that bronze, real bronze shininess left, and it's pretty desaturated. So for that, you can just control that by simply going and throwing in a brightness and contrast node, a hue and saturation node, right here where the color is plugged into the color of this. So to do that, we just add one last control in here. Shift A, color, hue and saturation, we throw that in, and now I can control the saturation. You can see the more you add to this, the longer it takes EEVEE to catch up, right? So my saturation here, I can really control my saturation and really play with these numbers and control just how crazy this gets, right? And how much the factor is. So no factor, factor, saturation. And that's one last control you can use on here. And then you also still have your control over here, your scale, and you have ultimate control of how much of this oxidation is covering your object. So you have quite a bit of control. So if you want it to be more green, you just go in here where it's black, push that up, and now you're getting way more green, way more oxidation happening, and so on and so forth. So this shader, when you build it up yourself, you'll get the idea of what's happening where, and then you can go and control all of these different things. And you can go from complete bronze to complete ancient destruction in one shader. And the cool thing is, we didn't use any UVs, we didn't use anything. This is just applying itself, projected onto a texture. So you can go ahead and add in whatever you want. You can go ahead and add in, like, if you want to do an input and you want texture coordinate, and you want to add in object or UVs to any one of these, you can go ahead and wire this all up and have it completely conform to that object. Or you could say object and leave it off. But the cool thing is, like, if I were to add in, all right, so I have this right now, this material, I hit this little button so I can apply it to anything. And so even if I delete this, this stays, right? So I can hit add and I can add in, like, Suzanne, right? Where is she? Monkey, Suzanne. Okay, scale down Suzanne. And I can go ahead here, drop this onto Suzanne, and boom. All right, and check that out. So now you can see Suzanne has this nice weathered bronze look as well. And it gives you complete control, and you can add it to any object. So we do this in EEVEE, and you can see here we do the same thing. If we check this out in Cycles, you see it matches up pretty well. So it's a good all-around shader that'll work in both, and it should work for you. With that, I'm gonna close out this video so it's not super long. If you got something out of this video, hit like, subscribe, share it, hit that little bell notification so you're the first person that sees when I make a new one and drop it. And go on and create. And hit me up in the comments if you have questions, and I'll do my best to help you out. Be civil. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.